must be the core of the Animus. No simulations, no environments. I can't even feel my own body. Everything's just raw data. So am I still me, or am I some kind of computer program? Home. I was born here. The farm. Yeah, they called it the farm. My parents, 2 dozen couples, some kids, a community. Hidden away. Small houses in the Black Hills. Right. The clear skies. Wood smoke, wind, the stink of gasoline, generators running day and night. I remember. We lived simply, almost like nomads, so far from everything, ready to pack up and go at the drop of a hat. If we were discovered, if they found us. The farm. It wasn't much of one, was it? Not a proper farm. We grew some food. I don't remember any animals, though. Maybe a few dogs. The Assassins. I was born into it. I didn't choose. It was like a birthright. You are an assassin, they told me. What did that even mean? Ever since I was young, they never stopped saying it. You are an assassin. You are an assassin. And this is our creed.
Nothing is true.
What did that mean? A world without purpose?
Everything is permitted.
Everything is permitted? Yeah, I believed for a while. But I never understood. That's the trouble when you're born into something. Belief without understanding. Everyone was so serious. Scared, too. All that talk of assassins, Templars, the end of the world. Every man has his limit, I guess. I can't remember when I stopped believing. When I stopped caring. All sounded so stupid. I couldn't hear the word Templar without laughing. And assassin? Forget it. Ancient war, they said. An endless struggle. But I never cared. Who knew it was possible to bore a kid with war stories? I guess I was lonely. Alone in a crowd. If I could have told them that, maybe they would have listened. If only I could go back. If I could tell them I'm sorry.
Memory sequence archived. Recalibrating Animus idle parameters.
God, I hated that. Ringing 5 days a week just before dawn. Up before the birds, me and the other kids.
Come on, Desmond, get up, no lagging.
Exercise, mandatory. A dip in the creek to get clean, then oats with butter and apple juice for breakfast. Ugh. I must have walked a million miles before I was 10. But it was nice. I liked those days out in the hills. The hush, the open air, the deep dark of the forest. Crunch of boots on the dry ground.
Can you see Rapid City from here?
No, that's much further east.
What is this war about? What are we fighting for? They never told me much. Just enough. They kept things shrouded. An air of secrecy. For my own good, they said. So we stayed hidden. Away in the Black Hills. If anyone ever knew who we were or what we were doing, there'd be trouble.
They're everywhere, Desmond. They have their hands in everything. Politics, war, finance, high tech, agriculture. People are asleep. And while they dream, Abstergo builds a nightmare.
Abstergo. The first time I saw that name, it was on the side of a bottle of ibuprofen. Mom laughed when I asked her about it. Can't get away, she said.
Well, we pick our battles, I guess. So many to choose from.
She told me the average American household contains 36 Abstergo-owned products at any given moment. If you tried to purge them from your life completely, it would be a full-time job. This was it. The global conspiracy, Abstergo. Fingers in every pie. Governments, corporations, universities. Mom and Dad made it sound so scary. But it didn't feel scary. An enemy has to have a face, but all I could see was a bottle of painkillers. What scared me was the training. Sweat, tears, bloody lip every once in a while.
Focus, Desmond, focus!
How far were they going to push me?
Strength, speed, agility. No excuses.
Couldn't stand it. What was the point? For years and years, I thought some major catastrophe was on the horizon. I didn't know what to expect.
One day you'll understand. You'll see. All this unease will be worth something. I promise.
If they'd been more open with me, if they'd shown me things, taken me places, maybe it would have made more sense.